Today we're going to talk about how to actually protect your brain against stress. Here's the problem. Stress shrinks your brain. It causes the brain to experience atrophy, especially in the hippocampus, which you nearly always see when someone has Alzheimer's. Now, fortunately, there's two parts of your brain that have the capacity to regenerate. Only two, not the whole brain. And it just so happens that the hippocampus is one of them, thank goodness. And then you also have the olfactory bulb, which has to do with smelling and the differentiation of smelling one thing versus another. The hippocampus is a structure that they're still debating as far as the function. There's a lot of theories on what it does. But it has something to do with affecting short-term memory, like some type of mechanism related to a relay switch to tap into your database of certain memories, but mainly short-term, not the long-term. Also, it can affect your ability to learn. It can also affect your ability to be orientated. So if you have damage with your hippocampus, you're disoriented. And that has a lot to do with this right here, navigation, because the hippocampus is involved with your ability to navigate through space. So if you were in a city, for example, and you had a map and you had to get out of the city, if you had damage in your hippocampus, you would have a difficult time navigating through this space and also remembering where you were in space. So you're definitely going to have problems to find out where you parked your car. And you see that with Alzheimer's. It just so happens that 80% of Alzheimer's patients also have type 2 diabetes symptoms. So it's not only the stress that can shrink the brain, but also high sugar, glucose, carbs can also shrink the brain. But what I want to talk about is what can you do about this? How can you protect the brain? Because everyone goes through stress. And so you want to do these things right here. Six things. Make sure on a regular basis you're taking B1. I recommend nutritional yeast as a good source. Not the kind that has the added, enriched, fortified, synthetic B vitamins, but the one that's unfortified, unenriched, you know, nutritional yeast. Because you want the B1. B1 greatly improves the hippocampus. In fact, if someone's an alcoholic, for example, and they become B1 deficient, they have problems with this and they start getting dementia. So there's all sorts of conditions that occur when you're deficient in B1 affecting the hippocampus. This will reduce stress. Number two, DHA and EPA. Both of these together are omega-3 fatty acids. So whether you're doing fish oil or especially cod liver oil or getting it from algae, DHA and EPA can help prevent the brain from shrinking. And I'm going to put some links down below of the research that I'm basing this off of. So you need omega-3 fatty acids. Why? Because part of the brain is made from these healthy fats. Number three, zinc. There's a lot of receptors in the olfactory bulb and the hippocampus for zinc. If you lose your sense of smell, that could be one symptom of a zinc deficiency. So zinc not only affects this, but this too. So shellfish is really good to get your zinc. Also, you can take it as a supplement. Zinc does a lot. It helps your immune system. It helps keep testosterone in normal levels. And then we get to number four, which is fasting. Fasting creates a very interesting effect on the hippocampus and the olfactory bulb. It actually increases something called brain-derived neurotrophic factor, which is miracle grow for your brain. So when you fast, you grow your brain cells back. Fascinating. Number five, of course, keto, low carb, healthy keto. Ketones are wonderful for your brain. Your brain loves ketones. They're anti-inflammatory. They can feed the neurons, even if there's damage and difficulty of your brain cells getting glucose. So ketones bypass the whole thing and feed the brain and help to keep it nourished. And number six is exercise, which can also help slow down or prevent shrinkage of the brain. Probably because you're flooding the brain with all sorts of powerful chemicals as well as oxygen. Okay, so you're gonna get a lot of oxygen too. And there's other things you can do too, like the hyperbaric oxygen therapy, and using different types of exercise, which I've done videos on. But these are the most important things to implement just to make sure that you can maintain a normal size of your brain. All right, thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.